Very much members of the press. We want to also add our voice to the ongoing issues that are being raised by Kenyans. The Assembly of Garissa County wishes to add their voice on the concerns across the country. As you know, this is an assembly dominated by the Gen Zs, people under the age of 35. And we are part also of the Gen Z's concerns. And this is what we have to say. We are addressing the recent and unexpected demonstration by the Gen Z's across the country. And in light of that, the president responded swiftly to dismiss his cabinet, reject the finance bill, rescind on the employment of the CAS, the resignation of the IG, closure or merger of 47 government agencies / prostatals, prohibiting government officials, including the state officers, in taking part in harambees, scrapping the budgets of offices of the First Lady, the DP's spouse, and the Prime Cabinet Secretary, among others. That shows the commitment of the President to listen to the concerns of the Kenyans, and we therefore request the immediate cessation of protests. We understand that these demonstrations are fueled by a variety of concerns and frustrations. However, we must approach this period with respect for the Constitution and the democratic processes that guide our nation. The President's swift actions indicate a willingness to address the issues at hand, and we must allow the necessary time and space for dialogue as tradition has been. The President, we therefore beseech our youngsters to dialogue and reflect on the importance of stability and order in our great nation. We all know that there is no pride in violence. Garissa being a case study of hosting refugees as a result of misunderstanding in their own country, we, as the people of Garissa, have suffered the brunt of hosting thousands, hundreds of thousands of refugees. Our country's strength lies in our unwavering unity as enshrined in our national fabric and national anthem also. We therefore call upon the Gen Zs to reflect on their action and calm the country. On this note, we also call upon the role played by, because of the role played by the media, we call the media to take their rightful role in disseminating the message and encouraging a peaceful resolution to the current unrest.
Hapo tumekutana kama members of County Assembly wa Garissa na viongozi kule mashinani ili pia tuongeze sauti yetu katika mjadala ambayo iko katika nchi yetu, hususan hii vita baridi ya vijana na watoto yetu kule Nairobi na nchi kwa jumla. Ya kwamba huwa wanasemanga kwa Kisomali, kama mtu hataki msichana yako na anataka bibi yako, Sasa tutamwambia rais achukue jukumu kama rais wa hii nchi. Ni hayo tu ndio itakuja kutusaidia sisi kama wananchi wa Kenya kuhakikisha kwamba kuna usalama thabiti katika nchi yetu ya Kenya. Kwa haya maneno tunasema mandugu zetu wale majenzi katika hii nchi, sisi kama assembly ya Garissa wengi wetu hapa ni hereka hiyo, na hatutaki hii nchi iende kwa mkono ya watu ambaye hawajali maslahi ya Wakenya wote. Na kwa haya tunasema na kwa rais tunamwambia, ikishindikana na maji izidi unga, tunataka yeye kama rais achukue jukumu na hakikishe hii nchi iko katika mikono mwa usalama.
Name's Honorable Zamza Mohammed, and I'm a nominated member of Garissa County Assembly. I want to say as the Gen Zs of this county that we sympathize with the Gen Zs of this country, and we feel their concerns are valid. But the president has also given much into, you know, the demands of the Gen Zs. And I think it's time that we also understand that the country has to move forward. And the president has also assured Kenyans that he's in to give the best for this country, and we are not ready to bring down a country that has been built for many years. Therefore, I urge the Gen Zs of this country, this great country of Kenya, that we should understand that this country needs more than our personal or individual efforts. Therefore, we should make sure that this country is beyond our differences, and we should give the president space to work so that we move forward as a country.
Maanta waxaan isugu imaanay baarlamaanka Garissa gudaheeda anagoo ah mudanayaashii Garissa laga soo doortay iyo inta la soo magacaabo. Waxaan ka hadleynaa waxa waaye wax qaranka oo dhan quseeyo Kenya. Wadankeena xaalad muxuu ku jiraa u baahan tala weyn in laga yeesho, maxaa yeelay kacdoonka hadda bilowday waa kacdoon jiro oo wixii jira oo dhabti laga hadlayay. Laakiin dadkii bilaabeen kacdoonka bilaabeen oo lahaayeen maartay wixii khaladaadka jira hala saxo, maxaa hadda noo muuqataa madaxweynihiin in badan inuu maartay kasoo jawaabay, laakiin inay jiraan dadana khaas leh dad khaas ku dhex wataan oo ay rabaan wadanka inay gacanta ka bixiyaan. Marka anaga waxaan leenahay reegaar sadaanahay qaxooti badan oo dhowr boqol oo kun baa nala jooga, dadka ayagana la joogo wax kaloo ay galabsadeen ma jirin. Wadankooda markaa dhibaato ka tagneyd oo ay lahaayeen wixii jiro xaliya yaa nidaamkii ka halaabay ku xalinayeen, oo ninka mas-uulka markaa madaxweynaha ahaa ee rabinay wax ka saxaan iyo nidaamkii saxda loo marin, maantana waxay sababtay dhowr boqol oo kun oo qaxooti ah inaan halkan ku hayno. Dadka ayaga dhakhtarin baa ku jiraan, professors ku jiraan, nooc walba oo wadanka uu ka kooban yahay baa ku jira. Haddana qaxooti bay yihiin, waa dul saaran yihiin, kabtan aan ku haynaa ku dhib qabaan. Marka waxaan leenahay arrintaasayto inay fiirad gooni loo yeesho. Intaas waa intaan isugu kan keentay oo cidaadaha idaacadaha oo la hadlahayno. Madaxweynahana aad iyo aad buu u mahadsan yahay tallaabooyinka uu qaaday, aad buu u mahadsan yahay. Waxaan ognahay in hadda la joogo wax badan uu ka tanaasulay, xataa wasiirada uu diray hadda inta la soo celiyey in badan oo aan ku qanacsanayn inay yihiin inta hadda la keenay ee la soo celiyey. Inta la sugahayaan aan filayno in maaragtay ay noqon doonaan ta tayo leh ay noqon doonaan. Marka waxaan leenahay hala dhagan ugulaado, fudaydka hala joojiyo, hala isgarabsado, wadanka hala dejiyo.
Kuna baadhi ya viongozi hasa wanasiasa ambaye pia wanajihusisha sana kuhakikisha kwamba wako katika hii vurumai ambayo inaendelea katika nchi yetu ya Kenya, ya kwamba labda wamekosa kuwa rais mara nyingi sana katika kinyang'anyiro, na wako katika hali ya kujihusisha sana ili pia wapate nafasi ya kuharibu zaidi. Tunaambia hawa wanasiasa wakae kando, wangojee wakati yao ifike na election ya 2027 wakuje kinyang'anyiro baada ya miaka hii kuisha. Hayo ndio tunasema. Asante sana.